Welcome to Between Heaven and Earth, an internet radio talk show where we help you connect spirit and divine guidance. Lisa Kay, your host, brings you shows that can enhance and transform your life with tips and new ideas for more happiness, abundance, and better relationships. Lisa is an expert on intuition and can show you how to strengthen your inner guidance to empower yourself. Each show is positive and uplifting to inspire your day. Her guest speakers are specialists on self-help, positive thinking, spirituality, and conscious living. Be the best that you can be with Between Heaven and Earth, conscious living for your soul.
Hey there, it's Lisa Kay, and we are back for our next episode, which is called What to Do When Your Intuition is Wrong. Or maybe the subtitle is Can Your Intuition Be Wrong? You know, one of the most frustrating things people experience with intuition is that they think their intuition is wrong, or maybe it doesn't work, or they don't have intuition, or they're feeling like, oh, well, my intuition isn't reliable. There are many reasons why you may think your intuition doesn't work. And usually that's when most people give up. And then they say, I can't do this, I'm not intuitive, or my intuition is unreliable. And they just give up on it. But there are many reasons why you miss your intuitive messages, what we call messages, or your intuitive information, your intuition. Everyone, even if you're highly intuitive, everyone, even those who use it, say, professionally, have doubts and at times misinterpret their intuition, their intuitive messages. So don't get down on yourself. Don't give up. You are intuitive. Your intuition works just fine. And it's true that the more you grow your intuition skills, the better you're going to become and less likely to have what we call misses or misinterpret your intuition. So let's go over some of the reasons that you might think your intuition is wrong, or the reasons, and this is something I go over with my students, explaining why it doesn't seem like it's landing. It's not, you don't have a hit, so to speak. So you might get an intuitive message or intuitive information that's about a possible future that hasn't happened yet. And so therefore, you can't figure out, you know, whether it's right or not. Sometimes this happens to us and we say, oh, you know, I knew that. I knew that was going to happen. And that's when we know that we recognize our intuition, because it is later rather than at the time it's happening. Or number two, it's symbolic, because our intuition comes to us in symbols and pictures and a word or two. And that's how the intuitive mind thinks. It thinks with symbols. So, you know, a symbol might, we see symbols all the time. It's something that humans are very attuned to. And part of it is because that's how our intuitive brain, or the right side of our brain, processes information. Also, symbols carry a lot of information. It's sort of like shorthand, right? So let's see what kinds of, we have symbols all the time. There, a flag is a symbol. Right? The flag of your country is a symbol. Let's take the United States flag. So what meaning does it have? It has a symbol of what the country represents. The 13 stripes are the first states, and then the 50 stars are the current number of states that we have in the country, in this United States of America. So it's a symbol, right? We have logos that are symbols of maybe a company, or it might be a symbol of a group that you belong to. I'll see if I could, those of you who are on Facebook, I could show you our symbol here. This is for our circle members, those people who are in circle. It's a little pendant, and what it is it represents our community, our group of intuitives that are part of this membership. And you can see, you can't see it on the radio, but you can see what it is it's a circle, and in the center is a gold heart, and around it are different colored circles that represent each one of us and that we're linked together on this journey. And on the back is the word trust. And that's because we want to trust our intuition. So that is what symbols are like and for. So your intuition is going to talk to you in symbols because that's part of its language. And you might be taking the symbol literally, but the symbol actually has another meaning. So these symbols are actually part of what you recognize inside of you. So for example, colors often are symbols for us. So when you see the color red, you might think it means love or it represents love. And I might think, actually, I know for me, when I see the color red, I what it means is anger for me, anger, you know. So you could also have symbols that are in your intuitive mind that you're not too familiar with yet, that maybe you haven't consciously recognized. Some symbols are easy to recognize, like I always use the stop sign, right? The stop sign is has the word stop on it, and it's a hexagon that's red. And so when we see that, if I showed you that hexagon that was red without the words on it, you might immediately think, oh, that means to stop your movement. Again, a heart may symbolize love for you. That's another one. In working with one of my students, I helped her discover her symbols. And one of her symbols for illness was funeral. And when she initially received it, she was confused. She thought it meant death. But as we started to talk about it, and in this case, what it was that she never went to funerals because it always made her very sick. She got very ill when she would go to funerals. And so she avoided them. So in her subconscious, in her intuitive mind, there was an association between funeral and illness, not necessarily death. So that's what symbols are. So you might get an intuitive pop-up that is a symbol, and you're not conscious of what it means yet. So the third thing is sometimes the message or your intuition is answering a different question than the one you thought you wanted the answer to or that you had asked. And so therefore, I'm going to give you an example of that in a minute. Or number four, you're looking for a particular answer that your intuition isn't going to give you. You know, we always want a certain outcome. And so we're looking for that. Or number five, you misinterpret what your intuition is telling you. That's a big one. Or number six, your intuition answered the question you asked, but you asked the wrong question for what you wanted information for. And that kind of relates to number three, which is your intuition was answering a different question. You ever have that situation where you're talking to somebody and you ask them a question and they give you an answer that doesn't match what you thought you were asking? It's because it was misinterpreted on their end. So this happened to me. So those of you who are familiar with my techniques, one of the techniques you do is to get your intuition to be triggered or happen when you want is to ask it a question. And so in this situation, I had a very strong medication that I needed to take, and it had some very, very uncomfortable side effects. And those very uncomfortable side effects only happened to a very small percentage of people taking the drug. Now, I tend to be very sensitive to medication, so I was concerned that this strong drug was going to knock me out with the side effects. And I was worried that it would immediately affect me as the medication was given to me. And so I used the question technique, and I asked my intuition, how is this injection going to go, and you know, what am I going to feel right after I get the injection of the medication? And my intuition told me it's going to all go well and that I wouldn't feel much side effects if at all. Well, I was hit with some really bad side effects, and it lasted a very long time. And I was really disappointed that my intuition was, quote, wrong. But actually it wasn't, because the injection went fine. I was actually surprised that I didn't feel anything during the administration of the medication, which took about 30 minutes. I went home and I felt pretty good. Nothing other than maybe a little bit tired. I was really happy that I seemed to have skirted those side effects until 8 hours later it hit me. It was not pleasant, to say the least, and it lasted for days. So was my intuition wrong? Well, it was right in answering my specific question, which was, how would the injection go and how would I feel right after it? I didn't ask how the intuition would affect, how the drug would affect me long term. And, you know, that was my mistake. So let me give you some other examples of how you might misinterpret your intuition. One I get all the time is wishful thinking. I've had people come to me wanting to know who their soulmate is. They want to know who they are, where they can meet them, what their phone number is, and all that good stuff. But intuition often shows you the next step, not always the final step. So in that case, oftentimes, the next step for that person wasn't so much the who the soulmate was, but what they needed to do in the next step to be open or be in a position for their soulmate to come by and to connect with them. So your intuition gives you clues on what might be blocking you to ultimately get to that final step that you're looking for, that final goal. So perhaps now, you know, you have to be open to your intuition showing you what to do right now, and it may not seem like the right solution or even make sense. Remember, you get what you get and you don't get upset. That's one of my sayings about intuition, and that it may not make too much sense at the moment, but it's your intuition knows the goal. It sees the big picture. That's one of its characteristics. It knows the direction you need to go in. So, for example, when my intuition pointed me to helped me get to a doctor right away to help save my life, which was my saving my life story. And I was having trouble finding a doctor. It pointed me to read a book on pediatricians. Now, of course, it didn't make any sense because I wasn't a child. Why should I read a book on pediatricians? But it gave me enough information to get to the right doctor very soon so that I basically saved my life. You get what you get, you don't get upset. You have to be open. Another thing might be ego. Your intuition has no ego. If you see that it has some semblance of ego in it, and I'll explain that in a minute, then it's not your intuition. Your intuition will never put you on a pedestal, or it will never put you down, because your intuition has no ego, it has no judgment. So if you think your intuition is telling you to do something to look better than someone else, it's not your intuition. Or if you think your intuition is telling you that you're a bad person, you're always making mistakes, you can't do anything right, that's not your intuition either. Our intuition comes from our right brain processing, and there's no ego, there's no judgment from that side of our brain. It's actually in the left side of our brain. Fear is another one. We are in uncertain times right now around the world, and I know there's a lot of fear going on about the unknown. It's a big one for us. We're often stuck in fear and worry of what might happen. But because your intuition is rooted in the present, in the right here and now, it doesn't dwell on the what-ifs. It doesn't worry. It's not going to be filled with the what-ifs. That's your thinking mind. So if you feel like you're getting, or you seem to be getting, a intuitive thought that says, what if this happens, or you're going to be in trouble, or something bad is going to happen, that's your thinking mind. Now, your intuition sees the picture, it knows the goals of where you want to be, but it really is focused in where you are right now. It will tell you what you need to do right now to be safe right now, or the next step to be safe, because if you're planning to do something that's not safe, because you're planning right now, your intuition will tell you that right now. Your intuition is calm, it's secure, it's not nervous. So you may wonder what to do when your intuition seems wrong. I've gone over some things that can help you figure it out when it's not your intuition, and you most likely followed a worry or a thinking scenario, which is not intuition, and it led you down the wrong path. Again, if you're working with my technique to get your intuition to happen when you want by asking it a question, then you can think about the question you asked to your intuition to see if your question missed the mark. It's not your intuition. If you were looking for a specific answer, was it wishful thinking? Did you ask a question that maybe was too specific? Whatever the result was this time, let it go. Trust that your intuition is right. It just might be your interpretation that was wrong. Trust is what gives your intuition power. So we want to keep that trust going. Now, one of the ways that's going to help you recognize your intuition is to know the characteristics of intuition. And we've talked a little bit about them here. Like, for example, intuition has no ego. It's in the now. There's no fear in intuition. You can get more by going to by signing up at lisakintuition.com. And you're going to get a list of intuition characteristics and how to make better decisions with your intuition. Again, just go to intuition.com. So all one word, lisakintuition.com. And you're going to get the characteristics and how to make better decisions with your intuition right away. All right, everybody, that's it for now. Thanks for listening.